Remember high school? Hanging out with your friends, trying not to fall asleep in classes, and making questionable choices was your daily schedule. But let's not forget high school's most prominent feature, the drama. But at Gahanna Lincoln High School, drama has a whole new meaning. Join us as we step into the lives of four high school seniors as they navigate their kind of drama on stage and behind the scenes. They have a lot to do, and it won't be easy. But as they say, the show must go on. This is Drama.
Emily and I decided to go to the shop and work on the set for the pound, so we were basically just like putting together our cages and that kind of stuff.
We're working on The Pound. It's a musical for the dogs is what it's called, and it's our dinner theater show, so people will come to it and eat dinner and then see our show.
PS stands for Performance Studio, which is like the top acting class at high school. This year in Gahanna Lincoln's Theater, I'm the stage manager, which means I'm basically the person in charge of like crew once it gets to the production phase of building and all of that, calling cues, all that kind of stuff.
Be really careful not to touch chain link.
I'm the shop foreman, as well as the assistant stage manager when it comes to shows. So basically, I'm just backstage helping Michael, who's the stage manager. And then in the shop, I'm like in charge of everything, so I get to tell people what to do.
Stage manager and foreman work really closely, so I get to talk to Emily a lot. We're kind of good friends. We work together a lot on little projects, like building things, designing sets, making sure everything just runs smoothly.
So school just ended and rehearsal's starting now, so it's the first time we've seen each other all day, so we're all just kind of talking and catching up now.
Gather around the piano. We can just go around this way too. So let's warm up with the finale.
Where am I at?
Yeah, why are you in the voice?
Mr. Odell is interesting. He's kind of hard to work with, if I'm being honest. He's just kind of weird. I don't really know anything about him, but he just like comes and tells us what to do, and he like, it's just weird. It's just weird.
Where's the beginning there?
Mr. Odell is apparently our accompanist and playing all of the music for The Pound. He's helping us transpose everything if we need to and all that kind of stuff, and he'll be playing live. But we're not really sure what he's doing now. He's kind of like the teacher, but also kind of not the teacher. So kind of confused what he's doing now, but for the show, he'll be playing music. Trying to form an opinion about Mr. Odell is kind of difficult because this man is kind of weird. We've never seen his hair. He apparently is an Uber driver, and I'm just really not sure what to think of this man. Camille and Melanie just walked in late. I'm not really sure where they were at. They could have been talking to another teacher, because sometimes they do that after the last class, but I'm not really sure where they were at.
Some people look annoyed that we came in late to PS, but, you know, they really shouldn't be, because, you know, they're not really doing their work in class anyway, so if they're annoyed, then they really shouldn't be.
But just think some things that I noticed. I know this is a warm-up. This is the life for a dog.
Oh, sorry.
Life for a dog.
wanted.
We're working on the pound. When our director gave us the idea, it was no one was on board, I don't think, but we kind of had to just choose it in the end because we had no other options. And I wouldn't say I love the show.
I do not like the pound at all. I haven't liked it since day one when our director gave us a little video to watch and said, hey, we're thinking about doing this show. And this video was horrible. I would have personally paid money to buy another show so we didn't have to do the pound. But that didn't get to happen. So here we are, stuck doing the pound.
You said something a student was going to... Who's our lucky contestant?
Mylan is raising his hand to offer to play piano for rehearsal. The funny part is, Mylan cannot play piano. I love Mylan, but he's kind of really bad at music.
Mylan, bless his heart, I love him, but he can't sing. He's, like, actually tone deaf, so, like, he can't ever match pitch, ever. We're in this little closet working on songs because Mr. Odell wants to work with the soloists more because he hasn't had a chance to do that yet. So he's taking them on stage and then that's just one person singing, but then every single other person is in this little closet working on the ensemble numbers because Melanie knows how to play piano, so she's kind of teaching us the ensemble songs while Mr. Odell works with one person at the big piano.
Where it belongs.
Yeah.
Well, he never taught us the harmonies.
Oh, true.
I'm playing piano for this rehearsal because I think the only person in PS who plays piano, and also I can read music and help people learn parts and stuff like that.
All right. I love it when Melanie plays piano because I feel like I don't know the parts that well, but Melanie is definitely helping and helping me understand them a lot better.
So this show is so bad, we've all collectively decided as a group that we're just gonna go off the book, create our own harmonies, because any kind of little pizzazz we can add to this show, we definitely need to do it, because it's pretty horrible.
If you don't know how, you don't need to worry about it.
I'm playing piano right now and I'm just trying to lead this rehearsal and no one is listening to me and it's just
the next one is
just annoying.
Can and go are the same note. Okay, do and keep our shelter open so we can go and hope and try and put those two together.
Melanie's playing piano right now in this little mic room, and playing piano is fine when you have enough space, but in this small of a room, it's getting really annoying because it's way too loud.
Okay. Do you want to learn the single harmony?
I'm a little annoyed at this rehearsal because sometimes I get annoyed I can't sing and the music can be annoying, but also because everyone just keeps talking and it's way too loud. Keep laughing today because one, Mylan's kind of struggling to match pitch. No offense, Mylan, sometimes I suck at singing, still kind of do. But Mylan's kind of struggling to sing, Melanie's playing piano, and everyone's just kind of screaming. So naturally, things are just being really funny today.
Sorry.
look behind me and I notice Milan isn't there, and I have no clue where he went. Milan's singing, it's pretty bad, to be honest, but I mean, I can't really judge. But at the same time, he definitely is the one who struggles the most with matching pitch. That's all I'll say.
Honestly, I think Milan is trying to hide behind the risers because he's bad at singing, because no one wants to hear him in the first place. Messing around during rehearsal because it gets pretty boring once you're in rehearsal for so long and it's just the same song over and over, and it's just fun to entertain ourselves and have something to do and make each other laugh most of the time.
About halfway through singing rehearsal, Camille leaves to go practice her solo.
One, two, and up.
Life could be worse than being outside all 24 hours a day.
Good, let's talk about freedom.
So, I'm having some one-on-one time with Michael O'Dell, and I mean, it's going okay. He just kind of tells me some, like, places where I have to change my voice a little bit. Like, he has been trying to tell me to say the morning sun instead of, like, the morning sun, but I kept saying the morning sun. He's like, no, the morning sun. And I'm like, that's what I'm saying. And so we're having a little bit of a clash right now.
That way, and have fun with those upbeats.
Okay.
So, because half the song is syncopation, so look at it that way.
Okay.
All right, so one, two, and up.
Like on the acting side in our school's theater program, I do a lot of like singing and stuff. I was on Broadway when I was 11 years old, and so I just kind of like came back to Ohio and started off again with GLHS theater. And Peter Pan was my first show at Gahanna. I was Peter Pan, and then I did Hairspray. I've done every show so far that we've had.
One, two, three, four. One, two, three.
You gotta jump in.
Camille can sometimes be annoying because she's really talented, but at the same time, she just gets all the solos, she's like the leads, and it's fun to watch her act, but sometimes you get sick of hearing about the Camille show. And I'm not even kidding, this girl has a website. My friendship with Camille would have to just be non-existent. We act like we're friends, but at the end of the day, don't really like Camille.
Back at rehearsal.
This is so hard. I can't play this. Okay, we're skipping this for right now.
Yes.
Clouds just parted for Milan. Oh, I'm just so proud of Milan. He worked so hard.
Milan just matched pitch, which is pretty lit because this could be the first time that he's ever done this in his life, and hopefully not the last.
We just finished singing rehearsal, and now we're gonna move on to dance. which is taught by Emily Rogers. And Emily Rogers is on a bit of a power trip right now. She's been given this title of choreographer, even though she's a student, which is kind of annoying. And she's kind of driving everyone crazy because she keeps going, okay guys, so I'm really big about spacing and, you know, you gotta know these dances. But we're all like, Emily, we're in class with you. Like, you can't just be, try to be above us all the time and you're just like not treating us with respect.
Beginning, certain dogs go off and then everybody comes ahead. Okay. So,
Emily Rogers is teaching us dance because she's the only one who can dance in PS. It's really hard. Michael tries to dance, but he just really can't. Like, I can get the moves eventually, probably, but Michael has no type of rhythm, like, whatsoever. And he makes fun of himself, but I don't know if he even realizes how bad he is at dancing.
Dancing sucks. I hate dancing so much. I am not good at dancing. Every single time we have to dance, I kind of dread it because I just stand there, watch Emily do a dance, and then think to myself, I can't do that. Shimmying looks easy, it sounds easy, I would have thought it was easy, okay. But every single time I'm trying to do this, I just look like I'm having a seizure.
It's hard dancing next to Michael because he keeps messing it up and it's messing me up and I can't get the moves right, so then I just start looking at him and then he's laughing at himself, but then I'm laughing at him and then Emily Rogers is yelling at us because we don't know what we're doing.
He just looks like an asparagus that's just being like thrown around the stage and no one can really seem to help him.
Melanie and I are kind of fighting right now because she's having the audacity to come at me saying I can't dance, which, I mean, she's kind of right, but at the same time, focus on yourself. Melanie and I's fights can be semi-real or a complete joke. Today, they're a mix of both, as usual.
It's just a good thing that Michael and I have never gotten in an actual fist fight because I could take him down because he is very small. Sometimes I feel some tension towards Michael and I just need to fake punch him.
You know, I can't blame Melanie because if I had to spend that much alone time with Michael, I'd be pretty annoyed too.
Sure, Michael and I fight and stuff, but we get along pretty well and we always make up. So I'm looking at Camille and she's doing her best, but ugh, it's just, she's having a rough time.
Camille's not really feeling well today, and she's just kind of struggling through rehearsal because she feels really sick, and she didn't want to come to school, but she came anyway because of rehearsal. I feel kind of bad for her.
Emily's been trying to cheer me up at this rehearsal, which has been great.
From the beginning, quickly, please.
Camille and I have been friends since the 8th grade. Been through pretty much everything together. She's definitely my best friend. Out of my friend group, I'm probably the mom friend. I'm probably the most responsible and I keep everyone in check and everyone makes me drive everywhere, so.
I just can't bear to look at anyone else right now because they're all just driving me nuts. And so I just needed to lie down for a bit and take it all in.
She didn't think that far in her planning.
Camille, this isn't Broadway anymore. Get up off the floor.
So Emily Rogers really wants us to smile during this choreography, and I'm not feeling it, but I'm gonna smile anyways because that's what we're supposed to do. It's what time, and he finally got one, so I guess we're proud of him, except now he has to get the second dance move right, which is going to be even harder. We'll see how that goes.
Just keep going.
Emily Rogers puts us in these small groups of four, so it's me, Melanie, Michael, and Ryan, and we're in this little box, and we have to slide around the box. And it's a bit of a challenge because Michael always forgets that we're sliding.
That was much better than the first time. Again!
We really need to cut these slides, but I don't think Emily Rogers is gonna let that happen.
I don't really think this dance is that hard, so I don't really understand why everyone is having so many problems with it, but...
Dan got it! You're a dancer! What are you doing? She's doing it right, and everyone else is doing it wrong, so...
Ryan's not the same thing. Honestly, I'm probably the worst dancer out of PS, other than Michael, but I just kind of like to assert my dominance as a dance captain, because I can dance.
This is a life for a
dog. If you ask me from day to day if it's worth it to be in PS, sometimes I would probably give you a snarky answer, saying, I don't know, can you dance? But at the end of the day, it's an astounding yes, mostly because you're surrounded by people you like and you're just having fun.
With one rehearsal down and many to go, find out what happens next week as the drama continues.